Sorry, you can record. Let me record from my side and let me share the screen. Okay. Right. So it is very difficult if you don't have index for a book. Imagine for a 1,000 page itself, it will be difficult. In the organization, okay, you will have crores of records. Okay, crores. Crores means you cannot even imagine. Okay, 270 crore records. 500 crore records, 800 crore records. Okay, very big tables will be there. Imagine for that tables, if you don't have index, what will be the problem? It has to scan each record. For example, you have 800 crore records. On that table, you are running one where condition, select star from employee, where employee name is equal to something Shanmukh. You are trying to get the employee information. Shanmukh will be very rare, right? Where rare means every name will be rare only. But you are trying to get the employee information with the name Shanmukh. Imagine on the 800 crore record table, if you don't have index, the same concept will be applied here also. If you don't have index on the 800 crore record table, it will scan each and every record, and 800 crore scans will happen. 800 crore reads will happen. That is very big pressure on the IO, right? You will have a lot of pressure on the IO. All the resources will be consumed. So it will be very difficult. So that's why usually we'll maintain an index for each and every table. We have to maintain an index for each and every table. If you have index, it will be very easy to search the records. Got it? So that index related information will be stored in the index page. We have a separate page to store the index, like how we have a separate page in the book for index. In the same way, we have separate pages in the SQL Server. This index page is going to store the index related information. Okay? This is all about your data pages. Okay, data page, index page, and your text or image page. Little bit complicated, little bit tricky. We'll go inside the system pages. Okay, don't worry. Don't worry at all if you don't understand anything. Immediately just, okay, raise a concern. Okay, I don't have any issues. You can ask the questions at any time. Okay, don't think like at the middle of the class, can I ask? Yes, you can ask the questions at any time. Okay, and don't think like maybe if I ask this question, it will be silly for others. Don't worry about it. You are paying money. You have to ask the questions. You are the responsible one to clear your doubts, right? Okay, if you have any doubts, there is nothing like silly or complicated doubt. Doubt is doubt only. Okay, so if you have any issues, immediately ping me. Okay, right. We'll go for the system pages. We have actually six types of system pages: GAMP page, SGAMP page, PFS page, IAM page, BCM page, and DCM page. These are the six system pages. What these system pages will do? Right? GAMP page. So earlier we have very simple, nothing is there. Earlier we have discussed whenever you create a new table, SQL Server will allocate a page from the mixed extent. The subsequent allocations will be uniform extents for the table. If the table is growing, okay, the subsequent allocations will be uniform extents, right? So if you want to give 100 rupees to me, what you have to do first? The 100 rupees should be available with you, right? Without having 100 rupees, you cannot give, right? So before giving promise to me, I ask 1,000 rupees. What you will do? First, you will think whether you have 1,000 rupees or not, right? Then only you will give the promise. Okay, I'll give the 1,000 rupees for you. Like that, you will think, right? Without thinking anything, like without whether you are having the 1,000 rupees or not, it will be difficult to give the promise, right? First, you will think it, okay, whether I have this 1,000 rupees or not, whether I can give the 1,000 rupees or not. Like that, you will think, right? So first, you will see the availability of the funds. Once you have availability of the funds, then you are going to give the same funds to me. In the same way, if SQL Server wants to allocate a extent, any extent, mixed extent or uniform extent, If SQL Server wants to allocate an extent to any new object, first it will check what and all free extents are there, what and all allocated extents are there, right? It can only give an extent from the free, right? It cannot give the same, the allocated extent, right? It cannot give the allocated extent for the newly created object. So what this GAM page will do, GAM means global allocation map. GAM means global allocation map. Okay, which records, which extent is free extent and which extent is allocated extent. Simply this system page, the GAM page will record, okay, this extent is free, this extent is already allocated. If SQL Server is asking an extent for the new table, then GAM page will search in the free extent. Okay, what and all free extent? It will try to allocate an extent from the free extent list, right? So GAM will simply records which extent is free extent, which extent is allocated extents. That's it. GAM will simply records which extent is free extent, which extent is allocated extent. Why it is storing that information? Why it is maintaining that information? If SQL Server asks an extent for the newly created object, then GAM page will allocate an extent from the free extents. It will not touch, it won't touch the extent, allocated extents. It will try to allocate an extent from the free extent list. That is what the GAM page will do. Next is SGAM. How it is going to maintain the data? Okay, in terms of ones and zeros. If bit one is one, if bit is one, then it is a free extent. If bit is zero, then it is an allocated extent. So whenever you are creating a new object, SQL Server will ask GAM page, hey GAM page, give me a free extent. Then GAM page will search what and all extents with bit one. Why? Because bit one means free extent, right? Then GAM page will search what and all extents with bit one. Then it will allocate one extent from that particular free extents. Clear? Any issues, any doubts? Right? Fine. Next is SGAM page. Same like GAM page only. SGAM means a shared global allocation map. GAM page will store all the extents which are free extents and which are allocated extents. But SGAM page will store the information about the mixed extents. GAM page will store all the information about mixed extents and uniform extents. Information will be stored in the GAM page. What are free extents and what are allocated extents, the information will be stored in the GAM page. But whereas SGAM page will store all the mixed extents information, all the mixed extents information with at least one free page, all the mixed extents information with at least one free page, right? SGAM page will store all the mixed extents, only mixed extents information with at least one free page, means one free page should be there in that mixed extents. Those mixed extents information only will be tracked by the SGAM page. Now, can anyone tell me, if you are creating a new object, SQL Server will ask which extent first, which page first, GAM page or SGAM page? You are creating a new object, okay? So SQL Server will go for which page, will ask which page? GAM page it will ask or SGAM page it will ask? Yes, SGAM page. Why it will ask SGAM page?
Why? Because SGAM page will store the mixed extent information.
Very good.
So if any create, we are creating a table, so it is storing in mixed extent. So
very good.
SGAM.
So yes, okay. Whenever you are creating a new object, SQL Server will allocate mixed extent, right? That why this point we have already discussed, right? This mixed extents information will be tracked by the SGAM page, right? So SGAM page will track all the extents, all the mixed extents with at least one free page, right? So whenever you are creating a new object, SQL Server will go to SGAM page. SGAM page, SGAM page, I am creating an object for the customer. Can you please allocate one extent for me? Then SGAM page will search it. Oh, okay, SQL Server, I am going to allocate this extent for you. Please use this extent. In that way, it is going to, okay, allocate the mixed extent from the mixed extent pool, right? The that is about your GAM page and SGAM page, right? So it is also same. If the bit is one, then the extent is used as a mixed extent with one free page. Okay, in the SGAM page list, if the bit is one, then that extent is used as an extent, mixed extent with one free page, right? Next is PFS page, very simple page, very, very simple page, nothing is there. PFS means page free space. PFS means page free space. What it will store, the name is saying, the name itself is saying page free space. Okay, so earlier I told you, if you are creating a small table, okay, imagine you are creating only this table, right? Create table, create table employee, okay, employee ID integer, that's it, very small table. Create table employee with employee ID, or else what is the use of this employee ID? We'll go with the employee name, okay? We'll go with the employee name. Employee name, and this is your varchar, right? Varchar of 100. Varchar of 100, right? You are creating a small table. Create table employee. Of course, if you, even though if you give one single column, means that is not a small. Maybe depends upon the records. We can discuss whether it is a small table or big table. So you just inserted two records in this. Okay, you just inserted two records, just two records. Now this is very small table, right? So even I told you, even though table is very small, SQL Server will allocate a single page for this table, right? You cannot store multiple tables on a single page. Even though the table is very small, SQL Server will give you a single page, an 8 KB page for that table, even though you are using or not using. Even though there are no records also, SQL Server will allocate an 8 KB page for you. Why? Because page is not shareable. Page is not shareable. You cannot create multiple tables on a single page. Right. So imagine you have only one record or two records in that 8 KB page. Means some free space will be there, right, in that page. Okay. The free space in each page will be tracked by the PFS page. Maybe a 10% free space, or 20% free space, or 50% free space, or 90% of free space. In which page, how much free space is there? In each page of SQL Server, how much free space is there will be tracked by the PFS system page. In each data page, how much free space is there will be tracked by the PFS page. Okay, will be tracked by the PFS page. Okay, it will be tracked in terms of percentages. Okay, 50% full, 50%, 60% full, 75% full, 90% full. Like that, it will track in terms of percentages. Okay, it will track in terms of percent. So PFS page will track all the data pages. You can ask what, which data page it will track. All the data pages in the SQL Server. These are the system pages. It will track all the data pages. Okay. GAM or SGAM or any page, any system page will consider all the pages, all the extents. Okay. So PFS page simply will track all the pages. How much free space is there in each page? It is going to track it, and it will track in terms of percentages, 50%, 60%, 70%, 30 to 50%, like that. It is going to store the free space information in terms of percentages in the PFS page. Okay. Right, next is BCM page, bulk changed map. This is also very easy. Bulk changed map. So anyone heard about the bulk operations? Bulk operations means, yes.
Like a huge amount of data.
Yes. To insert. Okay, so bulk operations, bulk inserts, bulk updates, bulk deletes, like that, okay? Bulk operations means huge data. If you are loading huge data inside the table, okay, then that is called a bulk operation. Loading means anything. If you are updating huge data, if you are deleting huge data, anything is a bulk operation. That is also one bulk operation. And if you are loading the data from other source to SQL server, imagine you are loading a data from Notepad to SQL Server. Okay, from Excel to SQL Server. Even though in the Notepad two records are there, that is also called bulk operation only. Okay, If you are loading the data from the external sources to the SQL server, that is also bulk operation. So BCM page will simply track all the extents information that has been changed because of bulk operations. Information about all the extents which are modified by the bulk operations. Got it? What BCM page will do? It will track all the information about the extents. Which extents? What kind of extents information? The extents that are modified by the bulk operations. Okay, the BCM page will track all the extents information. The extents that are modified by the bulk of means BCM page will simply track the extents that are modified by the bulk operations. Okay, say for example, I am inserting 1 lakh records. Okay, I am inserting 1 lakh records. All these 1 lakh records will not store in the single page, right? Maybe it may accommodate. Okay, imagine. 1 lakh records, right? Maybe it may accommodate in 2000 pages. Okay, 2000 pages means how many extents? 2000 pages means how many extents? Can anyone tell me? 2000 pages means how many extents? Each page is, each extent is 8 KB, 64. Okay, one extent is nothing but, yes, 8 pages. Each extent is a collection of 8 pages. Like that, we have 2000 pages. Okay, almost all 250 extents, right? So, if you insert 1 lakh records at a time, 250 extents are going to modify, right? 250 extents are going to modify. This modified extents information, this 250 extents information, will be tracked by the BCM. When? Only for the bulk operations. If any extents modified by the bulk operations, those extents information will be tracked by the BCM page. Okay? Information about extents modified by bulk operations. And when? Since the last log backup. And again, the condition is since the last log backup. Since the last log backup. You will have backups, full backup, differential backup, log backups and all. But it will store the extents that are modified by the bulk operations since the last log backup, right? Means, for example, if you took the log backup today at 6 o'clock, 6 a.m. in the morning, from 6 a.m., what and all extents that are modified by the bulk operations, those extents will be tracked by the BCM page, right? Again, if you don't understand anything, don't worry at all. Nothing to worry, okay? But some kind of tricky. I'll accept this is some kind of tricky, but it will be very easy to understand. Next is DCM page, okay? What DCM page will do? Okay, IAM page, you missed it, right? No problem, I'll discuss. Right, what DCM page will do? DCM page means differential changed map. This you can understand in the backup concept, okay? We have different types of backups, full backup, differential backup, log backups, okay? Copy only backup, striped backups, and cold backups, okay? And mirror backup, different types of backups, tail log backup, we have different types of backups, right? So mainly the differential backup, okay? In the, when we are discussing about the differential backup, then you will get better idea of this page, what differential page, DCM page will do. Differential backup means simply I'll give you one small, okay, discussion on the backup. Okay, we have mainly three types of backups: full backup, differential backup, and log backup. Full backup means it will take the backup of all the database, including data files and log files. That is called your full backup. Differential backup also will work like a full backup only. But say, for example, you took the full backup on Friday night. You took the full backup on Friday night, 10 o'clock. Imagine you took the full backup at Friday night, 10 o'clock. Okay. A full backup job is running daily. Every day, night, 10 o'clock, night, 10 p.m., that job will run. Full backup job run. So every day, night, 10 p.m., the full backup will be generated on the database. Then what differential backup will do? That full backup job will run at night 10 o'clock, right? Okay. So again, it will run at next day night 10 o'clock. So imagine if something happened in the middle of this full backup, say for example, yesterday night, Friday night, okay, 10 o'clock full backup happened. Today early morning 6 a.m., okay, your database is corrupted. Corrupted or something happened, okay? Then in that case, where is the safety? You have data till yesterday night 10 a.m., but you don't have data from night yesterday night 10 a.m. to today morning 6 a.m., you don't have data, right? So how you are going to get this data? How you are going to get this data? You can take the differential backups or log backups. You can achieve with any of these backups, okay? Right, so imagine you are taking a differential backup for every 4 hours. Every day full backup, every 4 hours you are taking differential backup. So night 10 o'clock full backup, okay? Right, so you just initiated differential backup for every 4 hours. Means it will start from night 12 o'clock, okay? Every 4 hours means night 12 to early morning 4 o'clock, one differential backup will run. Night early morning 4 o'clock to morning 8 o'clock means for every 4 hours interval it will run, right? So whenever a differential backup run, what it will take the backup, what kind of data it will backup? So it will backup the changes that has been done since the last full backup. Differential backup will backup the changes that has been done since the last full backup. Again, it will not take the backup of all the records. Imagine, okay, night 10 o'clock full backup ran, right? Night 10 to early morning 4, just 10 changes happened. Just 10 changes, 10 new records came or 10 new records deleted, just 10 changes happened. Your differential backup will take the backup of only those 10 changes. Whatever changes, if there is no changes, of course it will take the backup, but nothing is there, nothing will be there, okay? Right? So differential backup means the backup that has the changes, it will take the backup of the changes that has been done since the last full backup, okay? Every time, whenever you run the, for example, now 8 o'clock, 8 a.m. again, it will run, right? Every 4 hours interval, the differential backup will run. 8 a.m. it will run, right? Now I'll tell you, night 10 to early morning 4 a.m., 10 changes happened, okay? And early morning 4 a.m. to early morning 8 a.m., 15 changes has been happened, 15 changes. Now at 8 o'clock differential backup, can anyone tell me how many changes it will take the backup? At 8 o'clock differential backup, how many changes it will take the backup? 4 o'clock, 10 changes, okay? And 4 to 8 a.m., 15 changes, right? You are running the differential backup at 8 a.m. Now, how many changes it will take the backup? Changes means simply you are inserting your records or you are deleting your records or you are modifying your records. Anything is a change. Just guess it, okay? Everyone can guess it. I will ask everyone, okay? Just guess it. Yes, Vasu, tell me, how many changes it will take the backup of 8 o'clock? Just guess, it's not an issue, not at all an issue, okay? 10 or 15 or 25, how many? Just guess it. At 8 o'clock differential backup, how many changes it will take the backup?
10 changes.
10 changes.
15 changes.
15 changes, okay, very good, thank you. Okay, thank you for the response. Okay, Madhavi, yeah, tell me. How many changes it will take the backup?
25 changes.
Money?
25 changes.
25 changes, right. Anil? Anil. We have two Anil here.
Yes.
10 changes.
Think after 4 a.m., how many records we have inserted, those all the records will be take by in the differential backup.
Okay. So total how many now? At 8 o'clock differential backup, total how many records it will take the backup? After 4 a.m., as you are saying, after 4 a.m., 15 changes has been happened. So how many records it will take the backup? 15 changes it will take the backup? Or 10 changes?
Yes.
15 changes. Yeah. Anil. Another 15 Anil. Changes. 15 changes. 15 okay. Changes. Yes. Rajesh. We have two Rajesh here. Rajesh, how many?
15 changes.
15 changes. Rajesh Ishkwali.
Yeah, look at that differential backup is that fixed value, that is 10?
No. Imagine, okay. Just for example, if there is no changes at all.
15 changes.
Okay, 15 changes. Okay, thank you. Right, and Ritesh.
Sir, it's 15 changes, sir.
15 changes, okay. Saujanya.
25 changes, sir.
Very good. You are very confident. Thank you for that. Right. Fine. So the answer is 25 changes. Okay. I told you, right, whenever you run the differential backup, it will consider the last full backup. The landmark is last full backup. So from the last full backup, how many changes has been happened? 10 plus 15, 25, right? So 25 changes backup, 25 inserts or 25 deletes or 10 inserts or 15 deletes, anything. That's why I told you changes. Change means an insert or delete or an update, anything. So 25 changes backup will be, okay, taken by the 8 o'clock differential backup. So whenever you're running a differential backup, it will take the backup of changes that has been done since the last full backup. If you are running the differential backup at 4 o'clock, as the last full backup happened at 10 o'clock yesterday night, so 10 to 4, whatever changes are there, it will be tracked in the 4 o'clock differential backup. If you are running the differential backup at 8 o'clock, 10 to 8 o'clock. If you are running the differential backup at afternoon 12 o'clock, yesterday night 10 to afternoon 12 o'clock, whatever changes are there, those changes will be backed up in the 12 o'clock differential backup. So that's why you will have one recent differential backup that is enough to restore. No need to have multiple differential backups and all. Right, fine. So how it will track? Okay, differential backup. Okay, it will take the changes. It will take the backup of the changes that has been done since the last full backup. But how it will track it? How it will know what are the extents that has been changed since the last full backup? How it will know? How the differential backup will know? Or how SQL Server will know? You can guess it. You can guess the answer.
Based on the full backup.
Based on the full backup only. But one system page will help you to track the changes. What system page will help for the SQL Server to track the changes that has been done since the last full backup?
DCM
page. Very good. It is clearly saying DCM means differential changed map, right? That's it. Okay. So DCM page, what it will do, it will track the changes that has been done since the last full backup. The DCM page will track the changes. Changes means what and all extents are modified. What and all extents has been modified since the last full backup. Simply DCM page will record each and every extent information that has been changed since the last full backup. So whenever you initiate a full differential backup, simply SQL Server will goes to DCM page. Hey, DCM page, do you have any extents that has been modified since the last full backup? DCM page will reply, yeah, I'm waiting for you. I just tracked all these extents. These are the extents has been changed since the last full backup. Take it. Take the backup, and in that way, the DCM page will help you to take the differential backup. So DCM page simply will track the extents that has been changed since the last full backup. This and all like very important page. Okay, sometimes in the interview, they are going to ask you how differential backup will be taken by the SQL Server. What is the mechanism? How internally it will work, they will ask. How it will track the changes and also the answer is DCM page will track all the extents that has been changed since the last full backup, right? We missed one more page called IAM page, index allocation map, right? So here IAM page means, okay, we have one example, right? Imagine employee table only. Employee table having 1 lakh records. This 1 lakh records you cannot accommodate in a single page, right? Maybe you can accommodate these 1 lakh records in a, okay, 200 pages, okay, 200 pages. So simply IAM page will store all the pages that are associated with a single object. all the pages, IAM page will store all the pages information, all the 200 pages information that has been associated of a single object. Now tell me, I'll ask one question. Whenever you are running a select query, SQL server will go and ask which page. Whenever you are running a select query, select star from employee. So SQL server will go to one page and it will ask the details. Which page it will ask the details?
Integer.
Which one? Which page IAM it will ask? IAM page only. What is there to hesitate here? You are running a select query. Select star from employee means it has to load all the 1 lakh records, right? Select star from employee. Okay. Means it has to load all the 1 lakh records. Whenever you run select star from employee, it has to load all the 1 lakh records. All the 1 lakh records has been stored in this 200 pages. IAM page knows this table is storing this table is occupying what and all pages. This table is used by what pages? So IAM table knows, okay, employee table is stored on all these 200 pages. Then IAM page will give you the list of these 200 pages. Then SQL server will load these 200 pages inside the memory. Okay, so whenever you are running a select query, that information you are getting with the help of IAM page. IAM page simply it will track information about the extents used by a table. What and all extents that are used by a single object will be tracked by the IAM page, index allocation map. IAM means index allocation map. Okay, it will track all the tables and in which extent the table is present. IAM page knows in which extent the table is present. IAM page knows in which extent the table is present, right? So whenever you are running a select query, as select star includes all the pages has to be loaded inside the memory, right? So simply whenever you are running a select query, okay, your SQL server goes to a SQL server or SQL OS. Everything will be managed by SQL operating system. Okay, SQL OS will go to the IAM page and it will ask IAM page, can you give me all the pages that are used by employee table? Then IAM page will give you all the extents that are used by employee table. Then it will simply load the extents inside the memory, and in that way you can get the details. Clear? Any issues, any doubts? This is all about your system pages and data pages, right? Any issues? Rajesh, Rajesh Ispali, and Ritesh, Sauzanya, Mani, Madhavi, Anil, Anil again.
Yes, sir.
Fine, right? Everything is fine, right? No issues, I guess, right? Fine. So I'll ask you one simple basic question, okay? In which file these pages will be stored? We have two types of files, right? Data file and log file. Right, so whenever you create a database, you will get a MDF file and a log file. In which file these pages will be stored? These system pages will be stored. In which file?
MDF file.
In MDF file. MDF file. Any other answers?
Yeah, initially it was stored in log file.
Okay. Fine. So yes, the answer is it will store inside the MDF file. Okay. Yes, it will store in the log file, but not system related information. These are the metadata, right? Metadata information will be stored in the MDF file. Initially, it will store in the log file. What is that? Transactions information will be stored in the log file initially, not these pages. Okay. Only the transactions will be loaded inside the log file initially, right? So the system metadata information, like all these pages, system pages, data pages, everything will be stored. Why? Because there is no page concept in the log file. We have already discussed. So all these pages will be there inside the MDF file or subsequent NDF files. Okay, got it? Right. In the MDF file, pages will be there, right? Imagine your MDF file size is 3 MB. While creating a database, you will get an initial size, right? Right? So when you create any database, usually you will get a data file size. Imagine the data file size is 3 MB and the log file size may be 1 MB, initial size, okay? In the data file, MDF file, in that 3 MB file, the page 0 is a header page. The page 0 is the header page. For every database, again, there will be a header page, okay? This header is different than the page header. Header page is different, page header is different. Don't confuse. Header page is different. Sorry, page header is different. Header page, page header. Page header is a part of your page. Header page is a part of your database. Header page is the part of your database. Page header is a portion of your database. Okay, right? In every data file, page 0 is a header page and page 1 is a PFS page, page free space page. In every data file, page 1 is a PFS page. Page 2 is the GAM page. Page 3 is the SGAM page. Page 6, DCM page. Page 7, BCM page. Page 9, boot page. But again, don't worry. Nothing to worry here. No need to, no one will ask, okay, what is page 0, page 2, page 3 and all. Maybe sometimes they will ask, okay, what is a boot page? That's it. They will ask what is a boot page and they will ask about all the characteristics of the each page. They will not ask what is page 1, page 2, page 3 even. Why? Because they also don't, they can't remember, okay? It will be difficult, right? So no need to worry about it. What PFS page will do? It will track all the free space in each page, right? Like that, one PFS page will track 8,000 pages. Means in a single PFS page, it will track 8,000 pages. In 8,000 pages, how much free space is there will be tracked by a single PFS page. If your database is having more than 8,000 pages, one more PFS page will be there. PFS page is going to track how much free space is there in each page, right? So it is storing some data, means it will have some size, right?